you brew junkies, how you doing? Anarchy in the Brew K here, and yeah, it's a brew day for me today. What have I got planned? Well, let's take a little look.
Nice big sack of Marotta there, just waiting to be broken into. Right, specialties. I've got some Kerrygold, Melanodine, I used before, roasted rye, some pale malt in that one. Flaked barley, torrefied wheat, black malt. We've got some Challenger there. We've got some Brambling Cross there. We have SO4. We have some DME there.
So what does this all mean? Does this finally mean I'm going to break my virginity and become an all-green brewer? Not so lightly. I haven't got the nerve.
Yes, indeedy. It is a stout kit. Cooper's stout kit. So I'm going to be adding this in with whatever I'm doing here. I'm never too sure what I'm actually doing. I just like to get this stuff and just chuck it all together and see what happens. You know, experimental brewing, you know, a bit like that. Nothing's planned. Just see what happens. 150 grams of black malt going into the brew. Now, black malt, that does exactly what it says on the label, man. Turns your brew black. And that's what I'm doing. I'm doing a black brew, ain't I? Stout. 200 grams of melanodine. 50 grams of roasted rye. 200 grams of torrefied wheat. And I think I'd be using a bit more of that as well. Just opened the sack of this Marisotta, and I'll tell you something. Oh, the smell is lovely. Gorgeous smells. When you're just pouring it out and you get a, you know, a little guff of that dust. It's lovely, beautiful. 250 grams of flaked barley.
Okay, folks, my steeping water is ready. That is 68 Celsius, so it's about 155 Fahrenheit. So I've got my grains here. Put your rifles down, landing on your own. Lovely looking pear. They look like a pair of elephant's nuts. But anyway, in they go.
Stop your warring wind, only kill your brother. Loot your seas and sky, kindness to your mother. You won't be long at all.
I think this green bill is rather big. It's just over 3 pounds, so I could have probably done with it using a bigger pot. Definitely using some different techniques than what I'm using. But anyway, let's let those steep away. Temperature's holding steady at 67 degrees Celsius. Now, brew day would not be a brew day, would it, without the homebrew? Yes. And what we have here, folks, is something I did last year. I've still got one left. This is the only one left. Black Rock Bitter. Brewed in June 2012. So it's a good 10 months old. Let's give it a whirl. Heaven starts right where hell ends. She was young, 17. She felt
Well. That was a nice little pop. I thought it was no pop at first, it sort of delayed itself. That's nice. 10 months in the bottle, eh? Hey? That's not bad, is it? Oh, lordy, lordy. This looks... Don't spill it, Steve. You're bleeding sweat. This looks even better than me. I don't care about that. I don't care about that bit of shit that can go in. I can't remember what the ABV was at this now, but I know it was very reasonable. Yeah, that's a nice head, isn't it? What did they show? Two-fingered head. Yeah. Lovely colour. Lovely carbonation. Ooh. It certainly tastes different from how I remember. It's like a bad pint. Cheers. Up the Homebrew. Up the Homebrew. Okay folks, the hour is up. The steep has finished and I did manage to keep a great temperature there. Actually, a better temperature than when I did my pumpkin ale. Definitely, that's for sure. I think it's used in the smaller pot and everything like that. And before, I think I used a nylon. These mushroom bags are great. Don't burn. Okay, so out with the first elephant's bollock. And this, this is heavy. Heavy bugger. I've prepared 8 pints of eight pints of sparging water. Whether I'll be using all that, I don't know. Just get that drain in there for a bit. In you go, brother. Just let that sit there for God's sake. Well, I might as well leave that one to sit in there until I sparge this one. Right, all I'm going to do for that is my sparge water at the moment is 70 degrees centigrade, so it's going to be going into there 2.5 pints at a time and a gentle little blah blah blahs over there, and then we get the boil on. Okay, that's just been dripping slowly in there for a few minutes, and now for a little bit of dripping of my own. Right, the wort is now boiling, so I shall boil that for 20 minutes, say, before I add the first hop addition, which is going to be flavouring hops. I'm not going for bittering hops. I've got 6 pints of wort in there, which I'm going to be adding the DME to, and then I'm going to be bringing that to the boil, and then I'm going to add that to the can of well, so far I'm happy. Cheers, and up the brew. Half an ounce of the Challenger. The brew has now been going for 20 minutes. Boiling for 20 minutes, so in with this Challenger stuff. Do your stuff, baby, do your stuff. Look at it go. Get all that in. Yeah, that's all in. No worries there. No worries there, brother. No, I'm not using no hot bag today. I'm just gonna, this is only a small pot. I'm just gonna sieve it. And what I don't get rid of at the end of the boil, well, so be it. Okay, another 20 minutes and I'll be putting in half an ounce of Brandon Cross. Also, I'm going to put in a spoonful of the Irish stuff. Yeah, the Irish stuff. The Irish moss. Yes, the Irish moss. Beautiful. Tidy. I'm just waiting for the end of the boil is nearing. I may as well heat up the Coopers, Thomas Cooper's stout kit. Make sure that extract is all nice and soft to go into the fermenting bucket. Yeah, this should be a good brew. 5 minutes to the end of boil. Half an ounce of Bramlin Cross. In you go, Bramlins. Do your stuff, babies. Bit of aroma there. Lovely stuff going on. Get that in there. Right, yeah, there's the Coopers in there. As I, there's some more wort. That wort in there was just from sort of the sparging, just heating up. So mix the ME in with. Right. Irish moss. A spoonful. In you go. Do your stuff, baby. Excellent smoothness. Okay, so my wort is off the boil, and this is how I deal with things to cool it down, right? Because I don't have any of the gear at the moment. So it's in a bowl of cold water, and I'll just change the water over every few minutes because it soon gets warm to more cold water, and then that's how I do it. Anyway, while that's going, I've got some of this sparging wort here heating up, and I'm about to add the 500 grams of medium DME into that. For that, I'll use a whisk. Whisk it in, boy, whisk it in. No clumps and lumps in my bro. Bit of mess though. I don't know about you guys, but hey, every time I do a brew, my socks end up soaking. So I'm just walking around in like wet socks for like 2 hours. And everything is sticky. The floor's sticky, the units are sticky, everything seems to be sticky. What's going on? I'll have to clean it up though before the missus comes home. That's for sure. Because if I don't do that, I won't get to watch Emmerdale, Coronation Street and EastEnders. My whole night will be ruined. No, I won't get to see none of that. This year when I go onto YouTube and listen to rock music. And look at brewing videos. And all these Homebrew Wednesday stuffs and all that. Yes, yeah, so I've got to clean up. Yeah. That's about 3/4 of a bag. Put it in the marine pot. That's nearly a kilo. Nice. Nice and gently. All the GME is gone. It's all dissolved. No lumpies. Everything I'm using from this moment on is being sterilized in the most strictest ways. That's how I do things. Even a tin opener. It's hard to use tin opener. Oh, it's not really hard to use, it's just slow. I don't even need you, Mr. Tim Oakman. Fermenting bucket has already been sanitized earlier. As per usual, sanitization is paramount. If you don't sanitize properly, you're going to have disappointing results. It's as simple as that. It doesn't get any simpler. In with the Jeremy, nearly a kilo of sugar and some sparging wort. In with the lovely wort I made earlier. Oh, and I forgot to sieve it. But hey, shit happens, right? Go in with the hops. Well, a lot of the hops. I wonder what difference that'll make. Now, hey, if anyone knows what kind of difference that's going to make, I'd love to know. But most of the hops are still in there, you see. Me 27 litres. I put that the extra few litres in because that whole heap of sugar I added. Next thing to do is check temperatures and hydrometer reading, pitch yeast. It smells divine. Okay, so the probe has been in there for 5 minutes and it's had a bit of a stir and everything like that, and get my shutter out of the way. It's staying at a consistent 20 Celsius, so I'm happy with that pitching yeast temperature. So hydrometer test next. Okay, here's my sterilizing solution here, which I just used. It's Star Sand, but this is what I'd use for stuff what I'm about to show you now. But I don't have a wine thief or a beer thief. So I'll just get a little cup like that. And I steal that way. So I'm going to fill up the trial glass. This brew will not be going back into the main thing anyway. Put the lid back on there. And it's as simple as that. Secrets though. Brewers should never keep secrets about brewing tips. I'm not going to keep this one a secret because it's a shit tip. Right, a little bit too much now. And I'm going to put a whole drama trail. Well, I'm getting a 104.5. 104.5. I'm getting a 104.4. Well, actually, I think I'm getting a I'll put it up on screen what I think I'm getting. Okay, so the trusty Cephal SO4 is the man for the job. Dippy dippy. Look how gentle I am with it. Well, I'm going to get the airlock on everything. I'm going to stick a heat belt around it just for tonight. Give it a little starter. And go from there. Woohoo, my brew day is finished. So, airlock on, everything like that. Yep, heat belt on, and that's it. It's been fermenting for 15 long days. Such a long fermentation, I thought. Haven't carbs this way before, only used sugars to prime the barrel. I'm in for a treat. Let's stick that in there. You want to do it?
Yeah.
Bang! That was it. I don't think that nut was frightened enough. That was it. Bang! Bang! Let's get out a little rock. Hey, how did that get there? You're a million miles away. Now I'm the one that made you strong, girl. Now I made you stay. Now I make you stay. No, I could not make you stay. Well, Brewtubers, cheers. And this is my first homebrew stout, from start to the pint, and down the throat, and a dry one it is, up the brew. That tastes lovely, and it's not all my own doing, because old Cooper's stout, you know, that was the main part of it, and I just added some grains, done a bit of steeping, and oh, it tastes lovely. I've got a can of Murphy's in the fridge, and I think tomorrow or something I should have another pint of this and compare it with the Murphy's. But I know that the Murphy's just has a waterier taste than this. It's only 4%. This has turned out at 5.3%. It's lovely and carbonated thanks to the little 8-gram carbonation pellet things, or whatever they're called. It's got a lovely head on it, and it's as black as night. You cannot see through this at all. When the sun was out earlier, I poured one, I put it up against the sunlight, I couldn't see through it. So anyway, cheers.